There's no single correct way to adapt to climate change. An effective strategy for minimising flood risks in Amsterdam might not work as well for low-lying agricultural villages or for cities facing completely different climate risks. But decades of research help us understand the complexity and design solutions for each context.
It's wonderful to have so much research about climate adaptation, but the sheer volume of it also makes it very difficult for policymakers to understand what's actually relevant for them and where to find it. And it's also very challenging for newcomers and non-specialists in the field to understand how to approach it and where the questions are that are relevant for them. But to create some structure and understand the complexity, we've developed a framework of four generations that help us to understand how the questions relevant for adaptation have evolved over time.
In the first generation, discussions on climate adaptation were descriptive, creating a foundation for future work. What are the potential impacts of climate change? Who is going to be affected? Over time, discussions shifted. People realised climate change was closely linked to development, and that developing countries would suffer first and worst. This brought us to the second generation, with more normative questions. What does successful adaptation mean? What should be the balance of adaptation, mitigation, and development? Descriptive questions didn't go away, but evolved to reflect growing interest in the social dimensions of climate change.
I think that one critical issue from a moral point of view is that adaptation to climate change is an internationally led process. And even though it's very important, in particular for vulnerable populations, sometimes it's very difficult for these specific populations to really be aware or agree that it is a critical thing, especially if they have to deal with issues around food security or housing or violence or conflict.
The next challenge for climate adaptation was to build a policy framework that could support adaptation around the globe. How can we set our priorities? How does adaptation align with other goals? What policy instruments, institutions, and resources are needed?
Climate policy is important because it helps create guidelines and support systems for national governments as they work to adapt to climate change in their own contexts. The goal of policy is really to make sure that we've collectively agreed on our priorities and we can maximize on our strengths as we go forward.
Finally, the Paris Agreement was our collective call to action. This is where we get into the details of implementation. Which successful actions are replicable and scalable? What role should private investment play in supporting adaptation? How do we best measure the outcomes of adaptation projects and programs?
Right now, as a researcher, I am looking into a risk transfer instrument called index-based insurance, in particular for agriculture in sub-Saharan Africa. And one thing that has struck me is that there is very little evidence on what is actually happening to farmers once they actually use this instrument. So there is a lot of research about what will make them buy it, but there's not a lot of research about what happens once they have actually acquired the policy. And I find that quite striking.
The fourth generation is not the end of the story. Even now, as more researchers, policymakers, and practitioners join the field, climate adaptation continues to evolve. The four generation framework is a way of starting a conversation. It lets us channel this wealth of knowledge as we learn to live in our warming world.
Yeah, everybody wants coordination, but nobody wants to be coordinated, and that's what makes this approach such a good one to move forward together.